Welcome to the next series of for the engineering examinations which you are appearing for 2020. Now I am again taking some questions. Just follow with that. The first question is find the range of the function this. When we observe this question, we observe that this is a type of permutation. And the question here asks is to find the range. So, in order to find the range, we have two concepts here. That means we must know how to solve the questions of the permutation, and we also know what is domain of the function and what is range of the function. So, these three topics are included in this question. Now, I am going to explain one by one. For example, there is a set A, B, C, P, Q, R, S. And for example, it is matched like this. So, in this case, our domain is what? A, B and C. And codomain. Codomain is P, Q, R and S. But our range is P, Q, R, N. That means the elements which have relationship with domain, these are the range, and the elements, the total elements present in the other set belongs to codomain. Now, what is permutation? I also explaining this topic. How can we find out the permutation? Clear? So, we have the formula for permutation, NPR, and it can be solved as factorial N over factorial N minus R. In this way, we solve the permutations. For example, we have a question like this, 5P2, okay? Then we solve it, factorial 5, 5 minus 2 factorial, factorial 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. And here we have factorial 3, that is 3 into 2 into 1. So ultimately we got 20. Don't skip the video that thinking that I am explaining the little and easy bit things. I am explaining these things because the children who first time visit this video and don't have concepts regarding that, so they can have the concepts regarding that, so that when I explain this question, they can easily understand how I am proceeding. So just cooperate with us for those students who don't know the concepts of domain and range and how to find the permutations. Okay, now I am proceeding to the question. We have to find the range for the function which is given like this. In this question, one more concept is included, that is the inequality function. In inequality functions, actually, here, when we see in case of NPR, we observe that value of N must be greater than R. Value of N must be greater than R, otherwise we can not able to find the value of any permutation. Now, it means that 7 minus 6 must be greater than or equal to 0. This is the first inequality. Second inequality, x minus 3 must be greater than or equal to 0. And third equality, 7 minus x must be greater than or equal to 0. So we have these three inequalities by which we can find the different values of x. Just see over here. So we have, just see on the blackboard. So we have minus x greater than or equal to minus 7. Clear? Both minus sign get cancelled and we have in this way. But whenever we have minus sign in x side, we also change that one. So this is our answer, not that one. Whenever minus sign is in the x, we not only cancel the signs, but we also change the greater than to smaller than and smaller than to greater than. This is the main thing we shouldn't forget. Now in this case, simply it becomes 3, so there is no change in the sign because x is positive. Now the third inequality which we have here, we have to solve it now. That means third inequality is 7 minus x must be greater than or equal to x minus 3. So I just bring it over here, this is this, and here it becomes x plus x. So this question includes three types of concepts: concept of inequality, concept of permutation, and concept of functions. If you don't know all the concepts of these topics, you are not able to solve this question properly. So this we have 10, this is 2x, so x, this is 5. Now observing all the three answers, we find here the value of x is less than 7. Value of x is less than 7 or equal to 7. Value of x is greater than 3. And here we have value of x is less than 5. So when we add these two, value of x is less than 7, that means we have the value up to 6. But here we have the value of x less than 5, that means we have the value up to only 5. We don't have 7 in our set, and it must be greater than or equal to 3. So from these answers, we conclude, we just find firstly the domain values. So we have domain values, it is greater than or equal to 3, that's why we put 3, 4 and 5. So this is the domain for the function. Clear? Now I am going to solve. In the question, if it is asked find the domain of the function, then our answer is this. If in the question there is find the domain of the function, then you just write that answer. But now here the question is saying find the range of the functions. Okay, so in this case it becomes, we just put the values 3, 4 and 5. So when we put f of 3, we have 7 minus 3 p and 3 minus 3. So we have 4p0. Okay, now solve it using permutation. What's the value we have? We have factorial 4 over 4 minus 0 factorial. So we have value factorial 4 over factorial 4, that is answer is 1. Now f of 4, again 7 minus 4 p, 4 minus 3, we have 3 over p1. So now we solve it, factorial 3 over factorial 2. So we have 3. I think you can solve it. Now the next question, next value we have P5. So here we got the set 1, 3. And the last one we have to find, we put the value 5. Okay, now solve it. So we have 7 minus 5 P5, that means P5 minus 3, that means 2P2. Clear? So we have the value factorial 2, 2 minus 2, that means factorial 2 over 0 factorial. And what is the value of 0 factorial? That is 1. So we have factorial 2 and we have the answer 2. So our answer is 2. Now the again next question of permutation, and as you see on the blackboard, this question is asking find the number of ways. So this question is related with the permutation and combination, and moreover you have seen in the question that there are sets like this. So this question is combination of sets and permutation and combination. Now just read out the question. The set S is 1 to 12 is partitioned into 3 sets. So that means we have a set which we have to partition into 3 parts. And of equal sizes. That means the sets, they have equal number of elements. and A intersection B and B intersection C and A intersection C is null set. That means when the elements are chosen in one set, they should not be repeated again. Clear? So now we can understand in this way. That means if we have a big set S, it is to be partitioned into three sets. This is A, this is B, this is C. And number of elements in the set A, in the number of elements in the set B, and number of the elements in the set C, all are equal. Okay. Now, how does we find the number, how we choose the number of A's in which we have to fill the elements in these sets? So, for that, we just use the combination. That means we have total 12 elements and by in which we have to select 4. Now, we have 8 remaining and our condition is not fulfilled. So we have to take another set, we have to put the elements in another set, but we should multiply it. 8C, 4. Now we have remaining 4 elements, so they should be goes into another 4. In this way, we have the condition. But here you just see that we use the word C. This stands for combination, and formula for combination is NCR, that is factorial N over factorial R, N minus R factorial. Clear? This is the formula of combination. Because we use the combination because it is given number of ways. This is just a trick. You can differentiate here. Sorry. If the question has written number of ways. So we have put the values here. We have 12 factorial. Factorial 4, 12 minus 4, that is factorial 8. Now here we have factorial 8, factorial 4, factorial 4, and here we have factorial 4, sorry, into factorial 4, factorial 4, factorial 0. So it get cancelled with this, it get cancelled with this. So we have factorial 12 over factorial 4 cube. So this is our answer. That is, this is the number of ways by which we can partition the set S. Now the next question I am taking on the topic. It is given in the question that there are n points in the plane and we have to find how many triangles we can make. How will we that do that question? For example, there is a question, if there are 10 points in a plane, how many triangles can be formed? As we know, in a triangle, there are 3 points. That means 3 points are needed in order to make a triangle. So, in order to find these types of questions, you just write in this way and solve it. You can easily guess how many triangles you can form with the help of given points. For example, the question is good. It's like in this way, if there are n points. So our format, that means our formula becomes NC3. Clear? So I think it's very easy to solve it. So we have factorial 10. Factorial 3 and factorial 7, and I think you can solve it now. Now the next question, I extended this question to another word, just say it like this. If there are n points in the plane and n points in the plane where 6 points are collinear, that means they are in a line, find number of triangles in a plane, number of triangles formed due to points. That means total there are, for example, 10 points. Total there are 10 points in the plane. There are 10 points in the plane in which 6 points are collinear. They are in a line. So we are not able to make that triangle with the help of those points. So how many triangles then we have? In that case, find total number of triangles, that is 10C3 minus take the collinear points 6, 3. Clear? This is the base concept. That means we have the formula NC3 minus, for example, non-collinear points are P, this. And the question becomes like this, format question. I think this formula must be helpful in the case. I take one more question. If there are n points are, I will take that question with the number. Now, I have explained you how many triangles you can form by number of points in a given in a plane. Now the next question, it is also based on that topic. Let TN be the number of all triangles by joining vertices of n sided polygon. For example, there is a polygon which have n sided. I have made some sides, but I can say that this is n sided polygon. We don't know how many sides this polygon have. If and TN is the number of triangles, that means when we join these points, it made one triangle, and in this way it made lot of triangles. Clear? If so, TN be the number of triangles they are formed inside the polygon. So it is given, if TN plus 1 minus TN is equal to 10, we have to find the number of sides the polygon have. That means how much sides this polygon have. So how can we solve that? We know with the help of 3 points we can form any triangle. So we have TN plus 1 minus TN is equal to 10 according to our question. So value of TN is what? NC3. Value of TN plus 1 is N plus 1 C3. Clear? Now I am putting these two values in our equation. N plus 1 C3 minus NC3 is equal to 10. Now we have a formula. You must note it down and learn that formula, that NCR minus 1 NCR is equal to N plus 1 over CR. Applying this formula in this, we have what we have? NC, this is R minus 1, that is 2, and NC3, this is R. Clear? So N plus 1 C3 can be broken in this. Then minus NC3 is equal to 10. So both of them get cancelled. So what we have now? NC2 is equal to 10. So in this question, just remember this formula. Actually, this formula of combination is very helpful in solving lot of questions. That means N, we just add N plus 1, and R minus 1, R, that is R. That means here if we have 2, here 3, we just write only 3. Okay. Now, just solve NC2 is equal to 10. I think you can easily solve for the value of N. And the value of N gives you the number of sides in the polygon. That means we have factorial N, factorial 2, N minus 2 factorial is equal to 10. So how will we solve this? Just see on the blackboard. It becomes N minus 1, N minus 2 factorial over factorial 2, N minus 2 factorial is equal to 10. It gets cancelled. So now we have the quadratic equation. N square minus N is equal to 20. So when we bring it here, it has become minus 20. Now solve this value. 4 5s are 20. N square plus 4N minus 5N minus 20. That is N plus 4 and n minus 5. So we have two values, n is equal to minus 4, n is equal to 5. So this is the value, positive value we take. So polygon has 5 sides. So in this way we solve these types of questions. Now students, there's one more topic, one more concept regarding reputation in which lot of students have too much confusion. So I am taking that question. This is a silly question, but this is actually a question which often confuses a lot of students. So I am taking those questions side by side. So just note it down and make them fit in your brain. Now here I have the question. That means we have given a set of digits and we have to find 4 digits. We have to find, for example, we have a question, how many 4 digit numbers can be formed using 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That means we have 5 options from where we have to choose 4 digits. When repetition is allowed, that means if we take 5, then we can take 5 into 5 into 5 into 5 4 times. In this case, we can use same number 4 times. That means when repetition is allowed. And the same question is there when repetition is not allowed. Okay. So just to memorize it, when repetition is not allowed, I am giving you the concept, but I just memorize you. Repetition is not allowed, then you use your permutation formula. Proper permutation formula. That means total choices you have 5 and how many choices you have to select 4. Sometimes in some books it is given like this 5 factorial. So don't be confused in that, because when you solve this you automatically got this. That means when repetition is not allowed, so you have to use your permutation formula 5, 3, 4. And when repetition is allowed, okay, then the total digits you have given should be kept here and the digits you have to choose should be in the top, to the power. Okay. That means choices we have here and how many boxes you have to fill? You have to fill 4 boxes. That means in 4 digits, 1, 2, 3, 4, you have to fill either of the 5 numbers. So this 4 is on the power. Clear? And the base, total choices you have. Total things you have which can be filled in their boxes. Clear? So, if we can write here, formed using, for example, m digit and we have n digits formation, so we have formula m to the power n. Or I can write it as a total and for it is choices. So, we have write here total and to the power n. Clear? So, just remember that thing and here you have similarly total choices here, total things, and which we have to put here. Jitni digits number honge. Clear? Oh, I don't know how will you memorize it, but now I am going to explain this concept why it happens. Now in first case, repetition is allowed. That as I made the boxes, now you can easily understand, that means in 4 boxes, either we put different things, either we put same things. We can put same one here. Or we can put different digits. So, our answer is 5 to the power 4. That means our answer is 5 into 5 into 5 into 5. Clear? And when repetition is not allowed, then what happens? We have 4 boxes. Clear? So in first box, we can write either of 5. But in the second, we don't have 5 digits. We have now left with 4 digits. Now we left with 3 digits. Now we left with 2 digits. So it becomes factorial 5. Or you can say 5p4. Clear? So this question is very important. So revise it whenever you go for the exam. Don't skip this question. Now I am taking one more question on the concept which I explain you in the repetition and not repetition. Now here we have, there are 6 letters and 3 post boxes. That means we have 6 letters and we have 3 post boxes in which we have to post the letters. That means we have to drop the letters in 3 boxes. That means we have 3 boxes here. Okay. And we have to post them. That means either of letter can be posted in any of the boxes. So how many number of ways letter can be posted? So here if we observe, repetition is allowed. We can post either of letter in any box. Now total we have 3 boxes only. Only 3 letters should be there. And we have choices of 6 letters. So as I told you, t to the power n, that means t over here is what? 3. And to the power 6. Or we can also understand the thing which is kept constant. Because post office, post boxes are kept constant. They are fixed at a place. And letters can be moved from one place to another. So moving object is in the power. And fixed object is at the base. Clear? Now the next topic. Now the next topic I have taken. If there are 6 boys sitting around a table, find number of ways they sit. Clear? I know you know that, but don't escape. After these questions, I will take one more question, which is a very good question, typical one. If there are 6 keys, how we put in a ring? Find number of ways. Find number of ways. How we put in a ring? In both the cases, we have to arrange things in a circular way. But what is the difference which I want to explain you in by these questions? Actually, in this case, there are 6 boys and all have different faces. We can differentiate them. But in case of 6 keys, we cannot able to differentiate them. Here we can have 6 beads. We cannot able to differentiate them. So when there's a case when we cannot differentiate the things and they are putting in a round corner, our formula becomes n minus 1 factorial over 2. And when we can differentiate, then our formula becomes n minus 1 factorial. So formula for that becomes 6 minus 1 factorial, that is factorial 5. And here we have 6 minus 1 factorial over 2, that means 1 upon 2 factorial 5. Clear? So this is the basic difference and this is the type of question. Now I am taking another one. Now just watch another question. If A denotes the number of permutations of x plus 2 things taken all at a time. It means there is a case A in which we have x plus 2 things. And we have to find a permutation in which we have to take all at a time. That means we have to choose x plus 2 things of that case. That means for that A, we have permutation of x plus 2 taken all at a time. That means we have right x plus 2. Clear? Now, B is the number of permutation of x things taken 11 at a time. Now for the B case, we have XP11. I think the concept is clear now. Now, and C is the number of permutation taken x minus 11 things at a time. When it is given things at all at a time, that means the number of things there, you have to choose all the things. Okay, so for the C, we have x minus 11 p x minus 11. Now, these are the three equations which we frame with the help of our question. Now, if it is given, if A is equal to 182 BC, then find the value of X. That means here we have to find the value of X. For that, this question can be solved. So, we just put the values of permutations of A and B in our question. So, we have value of A is this. So, just use that one. This is the value of A is equal to 182, value of B, XP11 into X minus 11, P, X minus 11. Clear? Now, just solve it. We know the formula for X plus 2, X plus 2, that is P and N. That formula is factorial N. Clear? So, just write simply. We have factorial x plus 2, which is equal to 182, and here we solve it, factorial x over x minus 11 factorial, and here both are same, so we have x minus 11 factorial. So remember the formula n p n, it is equal to factorial n. Clear? Remember this formula, n, p, n is equal to factorial n. Now, it gets cancelled. So, we have x plus 2 factorial is equal to 182 factorial x. So, we have x plus 2, x plus 1 factorial x is equal to 182 factorial x. It gets cancelled. Now, there is a quadratic equation we have. Now, framing that quadratic equation. Now, we have this equation and we have to solve this using quadratic. So, we have 3x plus 2 is equal to 182. So, we have x square plus 3x minus 182. So, when we solve it, we have plus 15x minus 12x minus 182. So we have x plus
180.
So we have 12 x plus 15. So two values are there, 12 and minus 15. And the value should never be negative. So our answer is 12. In this way, we solve these types of questions. Now again, a concept-based question on the permutation. If there are n persons sitting around a round table, I am taking the case of the question again. There are n persons sitting around a round table. If two particular persons cannot sit together, in among the persons, there are two persons, they don't want to sit together. They are sitting at different places. As I told earlier, for the case of a round table, their sitting arrangement, we have n minus 1 factorial. But there's one case also that no two particular persons can not sit together. So in this case, our formula becomes n minus 1 factorial n p 2. Just memorize it. For example, if we have here 5 persons, then our answer is 5 minus 1 factorial into 5p2. Now you can solve it, factorial 4, 5p2. And I think you can solve it. So this is the concept. Now the next question. Now this question, there are 5 girls and 7 boys and we have to form a team from that. We have a question like this. There are 5 girls and number of boys 7, and we have to form a team in which we have 2 girls and 3 boys. That means we have to select 2 girls and 3 boys. If 2 specific boys who don't want in the same team, for that, for example, if we have to select A and B who don't want in the same team, for example, we just remove those guys from that and we make have a selection 5C2 into, that means we remove 2 boys. So we have 5C3. Clear? And in other case, we have, for example, if 1 boy is taken and we don't take another boy in that team. So in that case, we have the case 5C2, 6C3. Clear? So adding these 2, we get the result. Here, we just remove both the boys. We just leave those boys and make the team. We don't take either of the boys and we make a team. And in that case, we take 1 boy and not the other one. Then we have made the team. And then adding both of them, we get the answer. So just solve it. I think after solving this, we get here 100 and here we get 200. So total number of the ways is 300, and I know that you can solve it. And in the next series of the combination and permutation, I will take some more examples regarding that. And to check all the questions of that, I will make a playlist in my profile having the heading engineering test series. You can go through that series. In that series, I have made different types of questions which are asked in the engineering examination competition, whether they are physics, whether they are of chemistry, whether they are of maths. You can check them. And if you like, then please share with your friends also.